Hey team, Grant Hagen here with DroneDeploy. The Mavic 3 Enterprise just came out. Is this the drone that we've been waiting for? Let's check it out. So let's check this thing out. This is super exciting to be able to have our hands on it and to get it in front of you to really consider really five things that I think are really interesting points to consider as a part of this new drone. There's so much hardware out there, and one of the most requested things that we get at DroneDeploy is really which drone certain people should consider. And so we're really excited to be a resource for you to talk about some of these new drones that come out. And so we're gonna go over some of those things that you should consider about this drone as a part of your fleet. Let's go. Number one, better battery life. So the first thing about this is, it seems so basic, but it really is just a huge improvement, and that's the battery time. So the suggested battery time on this is 45 minutes, which is crazy to think about how long that we've been dealing with 20 and 25 minute battery times. And so any time that we can increase the battery life is always just a huge win. We see that you guys are shooting photos and panos and videos, and the more that we can do in the air to be able to capture all that is just a huge win. I think you're gonna get a ton of value out of just the increase a little bit more flight time. I'm sure a lot of you have seen that you're really close to getting all of your mapping and media done, but you have to come back to swap out a battery. I think that 45 minute flight time is really going to be ideal for a lot of the capture that you guys are doing. Number two, better zoom, higher quality capture. We have seen a lot of our customers really struggle with this balance between, do I get the Mavic 2 Pro or do I get the Mavic 2 Zoom? I too struggled with that. I really love the Mavic 2 Zoom, which we have here, that really gives you some really nice inspection capabilities when you want to zoom in. But then we've had a lot of people that have been using the Mavic 2 Pro, which has a little bit better megapixel. And so having that challenge between picking of this drone or that drone is really what's exciting about this drone, is that it's really bringing both of those two into the same drone. So there's some new camera capabilities with how you can zoom in with this Mavic 3 Enterprise, and you don't give up any of that megapixel that you would come to expect on the Mavic 2 Pro. So I think combining both of those two is a really, really exciting feature that we're starting to see in these Enterprise drones. And you're no longer having to choose between the two. You're really getting both of them in the same drone for you to have the capability to use those features. Number three, the mechanical shutter. The mechanical shutter, it's a game changer. This is the most portable mechanical shutter drone that we've seen. And I think a lot of our customers have been really excited about how do we bring that into a new drone into this. And why are we so excited about this at DroneDeploy? It's how it's making our data even better. As photographers know, a mechanical shutter is ideal for moving shots and therefore drone mapping. The mechanical shutter freezes movement everywhere in the frame, reducing the chance of image distortion as the drone flies and captures images. We see this rolling shutter distortion with the Mavic 2 Pro and other drones that only have a rolling or electronic shutter, which can sometimes decrease the quality and accuracy of the maps that we are creating. The solution? The mechanical shutter. My third favorite thing about this drone. Point four, the RTK module on top of this unit. The really neat part about this is DJI's continued investment into RTK. For those of you that have heard about RTK, it's really something that you've been familiar with for a long time. But for those that maybe have been flying the Air 2S or the Mavic 2 Pro, you're really maybe wondering, why is this something that DJI is continuing to invest in? And for us at DroneDeploy, we hear all the time, how do we increase accuracy? How do we get better information out of these maps? And the important part about that is this really eliminates a lot of the need for ground-based control points. Again, this isn't a video to go over all the RTK functionalities and how it works, but we at DroneDeploy are really excited to continue to see the investment into RTK as a module on top of these Enterprise drones moving forward. And point five, finally, is the smart controller. I know many of you guys have been probably using the smart controller for some time, whether it's on the Mavic Air 2S or on other drones, but this is personally my first time getting into the smart controller, and wow, being outside and having the brightness that you need, having it all built in, not having to worry about two different batteries, your controller and your phone, This controller is incredible. And I think at DroneDeploy, we're really excited to have gotten this drone as early as we had to continue to bring that DroneDeploy experience to the smart controller. And so we are excited to see how that continues to play out as we make investments into the smart controller. So on the flip side, there are other things to consider in here as you're thinking about this as a part of your fleet. Really, the first one is just price, right? So as these drones continue to have different accessories and come out with different controllers with them, the price is going to be more expensive. And at the filming of this, I don't know the final details of really how much this drone is going to be, but DJI has made it clear it's going to be a more expensive drone, right? We know that the Mavic 2 Enterprise has really continued to rise in some of those costs with having the smart controller and some of the different camera properties on there. And we continue to expect that as these drones continue to come out in the Enterprise section. And so the nice part about all this though is that there really is different options for you to consider as your drone program continues to grow. You have the less expensive options that we continue to support at DroneDeploy, and we are now continuing to support some of these Enterprise drones as they continue to come out too. As we wrap things up today, we've covered a lot of information of all the fun, exciting features that this drone's gonna come out with, to all the other things to maybe consider as you're thinking about continuing to invest in your drone program. Here at DroneDeploy, we are continually committed to your experience and making it as easy as possible to use these pieces of equipment. And so consider liking, subscribing, coming back to our channel for more educational resources on how to make your drone program the best it can be. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.